into my video, and I wanted to show you a little hack for these Marks & Spencer's LED light up candles. So if you're clicking on this, I'm guessing that you want to know how you can use this candle again. And I've been playing around using tea lights and little votives and things, and I just wanted to show you how I got mine to light up again. So if you're interested in these candles, they're sold at Marks & Spencer's. They're normally about £10, and they either come with like a neon light like this one did. This had a little bat that glowed up in the dark, which was really cool when it glowed on and off as well. And this is one I used over Halloween, so you can see that it's burnt the wax all the way down to the bottom. And then there's a little metal bit down at the bottom here, and this bit is the heat sensor. So all you've got to do is light that, and that will make it light up. So let me just show you very quickly. There you go. So now the bat is on. But then as soon as I take this away, once the heat has gone, it will go off. So what I decided to do was to get some more heat down there. This is another one which came with a lovely London scene. I must admit, from a distance though, you couldn't really see the scene that well. But you can see that I've already put another candle in here, so I'll show you what I did. So the candle I've put in here is a Yankee Candle votive. So it was the same size as this. So let me light this up and then you can see what it looks like with the LED lights on. So the lights have come on again, so yeah, it's rejuvenated. So I'm just going to put this one in the background, then I'll try and do the same with the bat one, just to show you what to do. So this is the one that I'm going to use, and this was a little gingerbread votive candle, and I have cut it 2/3 of the way down, and the wick is still going through the middle. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to cut that wick so that I've got it for the top of the candle. So I'm just going to cut it down there. There we go, so you've got the two halves of the candle now. There you go, so I've just squashed it down there and it's steady, so it is sitting, it is pressed down slightly onto that metal sensor. So let's light it. And with the other one, it didn't light up straight away, because don't forget, it is based on heat. So let's see what happens with this one. Okay, so this one has lit up immediately. So there you go. So this one's even better than this one. Took about an hour to warm up until the heat, some of the wax had melted down to the bottom of the candle. But yeah, this one's going again. So I'm really pleased with that. I actually loved this one for Halloween. I thought it was so cool. Now this is one that I got for Valentine's Day last year. And this one actually looks nice even without the LED lights, because the heart does show up quite well. Let me just show you with a little tea light. So this one, I've just set a tea light down at the bottom there. So there you go, that's that one lit up again. And I personally think this one, particularly with the heart design, looks really good on its own. But I'm still going to see if I can get the LEDs to light up as well. Also, when you cut off the bottom of the candle or the votive, don't throw it away, because you can still burn this. You can either burn it in a wax melt, or otherwise, what I did yesterday is I stuck some bits around the edge of the candle that I'd already put in there. So I've done the same thing again. I've got a votive candle here that I have cut the bottom off. The reason I've cut off the bottom is because of that metal bit down there, which is the base of the wick. So I'll pop this in the candle and let's see if it works. So there you go, it's just in the bottom of the candle there. So it's sitting on top of that heat sensor. Okay, so the little heart candle, what I had to do is I had to let it burn down a little bit, so it's just been burning away for about 20 minutes, but now you can see that the little LED lights have come on. So yeah, I just think you just need to be a little bit patient. I personally would probably get thinner candles because then you can cut them into more sections, and also it's safer to cut a thinner candle than it is these votives. But yeah, that's how I get to use them again. So I'm particularly pleased about the bat though, because the bat is the one that I really wanted to use again for Halloween this year. So yeah, I'm really pleased that one is working. And also with this one, you get some little designs going around the edge as well, so you get little sparkly lights. So yeah, so let me know if you found this review and little trick handy. I love candles, so I probably will have a little another candle haul coming up as well. So yes, if you have one of these candles, give it a go. Let me know if you managed to do it yourself. And one of my subscribers has done it, as I said, so she used a thinner candle and she did the same thing. But I don't have those handy, so that's why I decided to give it a go with the votives. So thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you found it helpful, and hopefully I will catch you on another one.